Hi everyone, welcome to the Jenkins Infra weekly team meeting. Today you don't have Damien du Portal as in holidays, as he is on holidays, so I will make everything possible to replace him, even if he's not replaceable. I'm sorry. Today around the table we have, I'm sorry, Jay is not there, but should arrive soon. We got Mark. Hello, Mark. Myself and Kevin Martins. Hello, Kevin. We are today the 1st of October 2024. For the announcement today, last week already, the last weekly release went well, the 2.4778. But today's release was postponed to tomorrow because of a security release. We will have both the core and weekly with that security release, which we can have some news around that link. Here is the pre-announcement. So tomorrow, Wednesday too, the IS security severity is medium. So tomorrow we will have both the core and weekly update. The next weekly will be on the 8th of October. We go back to every Tuesday. The number, if I'm not wrong, should be 2.480. The next LTS will be tomorrow. Christian is the release lead, and the number is 2.462.3. And yes, the next major event will be the FOSDEM 2025 in Brussels, the 1 and 2 of February. Mark, do we talk about the 31 of January?
Yes, absolutely. We can talk about it. So the plan right now is that we will do a contributor summit 31 January. Bruno Verachten is planning the agenda and Alyssa Tong is arranging the venue.
Perfect. All right. Well, I let you take the note because I'm not able to speak and take the note.
I will
I'm not
happily do
Damien.
that.
I'm sorry. So as for the cloud budget, I was able to extract few data on the cloud budget. I should say that the forecast for October might be quite wrong because we're only the 1st of October. What's interesting is the last month's cost. We have for the CDF paid Azure account for September, we are less than 4,000K. I said consume because I'm not quite sure, but the invoice, it may be $100 a month because we have the monthly support. I'm not sure it's included or not in the number I got. So we are less than 4,000K, 4K, $4,000. For the Azure sponsorship for September, we are at 8,000, but I have no access to that account. Only Damien can check the numbers. So I left the last of last week. But I cannot update those numbers. So for the Azure sponsorship, we will have to wait for Damien's coming back to have news. For DigitalOcean, we are still around the $200 of consumption for September. That should stay around that amount every month until the end of the account, except if we move. Like that was planned, the few VM from the CloudBees AWS account to DigitalOcean.
Yeah, no, on DigitalOcean, I saw a bill just arrive today in my email that said 2,150 something. So it was actually 158.84.
Oh,
But I'm not sure I understand the email I received at the time.
I went this morning with Jay on the DigitalOcean account, so maybe I
Perfect.
make something
No,
wrong. Go check.
your data, neither of those is a concern. Let's not spend the time to check.
So it's Maximum 200, maybe 150.
Exactly. It might have
Good.
been as low as 160, and it might be as high as 200. In either case, it's fine.
And when I see that September is exactly the same than August, I tend to trust you and not me. Maybe
Well, but again,
we
I
screwed
don't
up.
think it's worth us doing the research.
Okay.
That's great.
As for AWS, we got two accounts, the CloudBees account. We kept around 6K, 6.1. October, there is no data yet. We planned the huge move of update Jenkins.io that will lower a lot that account, but it's postponed because on the last brown test, who forgot the name,
Brown out.
we run out. Thank you. We found out a few issues that we need to take care of. We will talk about that later. But right now, we should stay around 6K for the next month. As for the sponsor account, we just started to use it with Jay. That's our playground. And we start the moving that is, we're talking here. We started to plan the moving of ci.jenkins.io with the controller and all the agents and all the infrastructure on that new account. Work in progress for the probably the next month, this month or October. It's right there.
Oh, it's already there. Okay, good. Oh,
That's fine.
good.
I mean,
I didn't
that's
no help.
okay.
Good.
Okay, what have we done? Mark worked a lot because he did handle the four issues on Jira spamming. I don't think we need to go around that. It's okay. Thank you, Mark. We managed a few Terraform credentials that were that we needed to be rotated. We confirmed that the update CLI process went well and was very every step were very clear and easy to follow. So we did that with Damien and it worked. The new AWS sponsor account is now available for both Jay and I. We are using some MFA and very secure access. Everything is done and proceed, and we managed to have at the same time the UI access and the CLI access, and we checked with Jay that both of us can use the Terraform, so we can go ahead with the plan. This one is for Jay. Do you want to explain, Jay, what you did than that?
Yeah, so according to James, we need to introduce entropy into our agent virtual machines. And initially, we went for the idea that we would use two or more tools. So in the initial plan was to go for RNGD and Hapget to produce the required entropy. But after we started and implemented a few tools, we found out that we were getting the same amount of entropy, which is using the installation of RNGD on our trusted agent. We decided to maintain feature parity. We just decided to remove the installation of Hapget from the other agents, which we already installed the Hapget tool. And also the same. So we now have RNGD across all our agents, including the permanent ones such as Trusted and S390X.
Yes, and we've
So
checked
yeah,
that
it
the entropy
includes
was okay.
the issue.
Thank you,
Yeah.
Jay.
So there was a de thank you. There was a test condition that James had asked us, a test pipeline that James had asked us to execute, which we did, and we got the desired results. So yeah, we can close the issue, and our agents now have enough entropy to be FIPS compliant.
And we took the advantage to make sure that both Jay and I had access and SSH on the S390X machine. And we did reboot it, if I remember correctly, yesterday too. So that's what
yes, we did.
We've done. Okay, thank you, Jay.
Everything's done on the S390X.
I don't hear you well, but yes, everything is okay.
I'm having some network issues. I really apologize for that.
Thank you, Jay. Close as not planned is a plugin trend stat page. We can have a look, but it seems that was related to a browser plugin ad blocker that was the cause of all the problems. So nothing to do, it was solved by that person herself. Work in progress. So the main epic challenge for both Jay and I this month during Damien vacation is to prepare the migration from for CA Jenkins.io from the Azure sponsorship to the AWS sponsorship to make sure we have enough sponsored cash left on the Azure sponsorship until the month of I forgot which month, but this one is getting longer than the other one. Azure until May 2025, sorry, and start using the AWS sponsored account, which is untouched now. That process, that epic, is split in a multitude of multiple small issues, not small, but other issues. First one is dealing with the network. Right now, I'm working on that part, preparing a draft from Terraform to handle everything we need. Yes, and I'm taking advantage of Jay having a tutorial on Terraform to help me out to check if I'm not wrong, if I'm going in the good direction, and if I'm fulfilling everything. And by explaining Jay how I manage this thing, I make sure I'm following every step in there. So that's our work in progress daily. Next step will be to start the AKS cluster also, which should bring together the site services we're using as Datadog, the ACP, and also the Docker proxy. That will prepare the next issues with the ACR is here, which will embed the agents, VM agents and Kubernetes agents, and last but not least, the controller. That will probably take us a few weeks, but that's work in progress. We have set to renew, and for Jay, we have to update the update CLI manifest to be of better usage. Right now, we are missing expiration date. That's not the expiration date. That's the this one is the next date. So we need to make sure that's the expiration date we put in there, and that the scope is not wrong. It's not clear enough. So we need to update the update CLI, and we need to rotate those two page foot before the 6th of October. So we'll deal with that during the weekend. Am I signing myself right now? And I will deal with that. For the infra statistic, last time we spoke about that, we were stuck because Kosuke is handling that part of collecting and preparing those data, and it was out of the VPN. Damien managed to deal with Kosuke, and Kosuke now have the VPN. So we just need to make sure that the machine is able to send the statistic and that everything is working fine. I think the ball is in Tim Jacomb's hand and is following, if I understood correctly.
I think actually it's in Andrew Bayer's hands, but you're right. It's not Kosuke. It's the next person, I believe, is Andrew Bayer, because Kosuke, once having connected the system, now Andrew needs to take the next step.
Do you think we need to ping him here?
I thought that Damien had already pinged him. So it's worth mentioning. Let me put a mention in there to Andrew. That's a good one for me to check.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. I raised my hand by just raising my hand. I don't know how to unraise my hand. I'm sorry.
Under the React button, there is a raise hand, which should also lower hand.
I don't have any React button visible.
Oh, at the bottom of my screen, or on the control bar that controls. You probably don't have a control bar either, do you?
I have the control bar now.
Okay, I'll just lower your hand. Solved.
Thank you. Was looking for that.
All right.
Next, Gradle plugin use proprietary dependency. If I understand correctly, that's in the Daniel Beck. Daniel Beck is following. That's not in his hand, and he asked to the developer to provide. Oh, you're in there too. To provide a patch for the other release too.
Right, and so this one is making very good progress. So okay, they found what I'd call an ideal solution. We were worried that the solution might require complete removal of everything and no way to run Gradle. But in what they did was they separated the proprietary component out, and they download the proprietary component when they need it, and so that now makes the plugin that they deliver from Jenkins is now fully open source as it needs to be. But what they're now working through is how do they release a version of that plugin that is the older Jenkins baseline. And we've given them some guidance on steps to take to test it, etc.
Awesome. I like the obligatory note of the security team member. Nobody should run Jenkins older than 2.452.3, and older than 2.426.3 is insanity.
Yes, correct.
Thank you, Danielle.
Right. The very real thing is there have been, in the last 12 months, there have been two or more critical security vulnerabilities disclosed for Jenkins. And we know one of the two has publication of exploits in the wild. If you're running a public-facing Jenkins controller, you must upgrade to current version. Now, we don't support anything other than current version, so you should upgrade anyway, but you must upgrade. Yeah, very good.
Yes, thank you. So, that one is for me. The Max IP, I haven't had time to work on that. That's the main issue. The sub-issue is this one. I did manage to create a cron job that embed the update geo IP and the AZ copy software. I am stuck because now I need to make sure that I also got AZ command within that pod, that image, because the script we're using to create token that are 5 minutes token, need the AZ command. So now I need to improve my image. I didn't have time to deal with that, but I'm on it. Work in progress. It's not emergency, so of course that's a backhand. How you call that? Back task. To host. Oh, but we did that one. We did that one, I think. What's the status on that? This one is the new stat Jenkins.io. And we did that. So it's closed by that location, the pull request I did. So redirection now. Oh, okay. No, working. This means that with the work that Hervé did, providing the old data from the old stat website to the new stat, we got both files replied on the new stats Jenkins.io. So people using the old path will still have their request. If they call an existing path on the URL of the old stat Jenkins.io, they will got 404 error. If we do call an existing files in the new URL of the new stats Jenkins.io, we will be redirected by the JS routing, the JavaScript routing. So we got both website combined in one. I'm not sure I'm really clear on that, but it's a good job. Thank you, Hervé, by the way, because he did manage to have the old one in the new one. And the huge task of migrating update Jenkins.io have been postponed because during the last runout, we discovered that a few page embedded relative path. So when we use those, the redirection is not working because the domain name changed for West Europe or East America dot on Cloudflare, and we think that the best solution would be to change those paths to absolute paths, because we will be able to still use that geolocalization and that high availability through the mirror bits architecture. So there is a new issue opened to find ways to generate the page with absolute link instead of relative links. And yes, Daniel found a few error on the JSON generation. We had to set up new health check, and that was very interesting. We bumped into few little thing on that fourth run out, so it was very useful. In fact, we thought we have found everything, but no. For example, on the Cloudflare, we had to uncheck a browser integrity check, BIC, that was locking the redirection from Java. So when a Java controller was trying to use it, sometimes, not much, but some users were locked because of that browser integrity check. We had to uncheck that in Cloudflare to make sure that our clients were all having the same redirections. That was very interesting. So that process and all that will probably have to wait for Damien. Maybe the generation can be handled by Daniel. I don't know. I need to check that with him.
Good.
For the new issues, so as I told you, our plan during then Damien's holidays is to prepare the migration for CI Jenkins.io from Azure to AWS. We need to set up everything back on AWS. So defining the network, defining the resources, Kubernetes, VM, everything. So that's the plan. We got the epic issues and all the sub issues. We need to upgrade Maven for GitHub Action. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so we need to take care of that.
And there are already several competing proposals out there to be sure that we get the right thing. Jesse Glick has offered one. He and Basil are under discussion on what does it take to do this. What's the right way to decide how to download? There are two different actions, neither of which is from GitHub itself, which is really surprising. Maven is such a crucial component. You'd expect GitHub would provide an action to choose the exact Maven version, but apparently they don't. So they're compromising between use one of these, rely on one of these others, or just download it ourselves and install it.
Okay. And that discussion is where?
I believe if you look in, I don't know, I'll have to link to it because I've seen it, and I'll have to provide links to it.
Thank you, Mark.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so this one will wait a little for them to be all agreed. Build error appeal to be infra related. So we got some stuff. I haven't seen that. Chris, okay. Okay, I have no clue what to do on that, but we'll have a look.
Okay.
Main branch, okay.
Yeah, docs.jenkins.io is not a critical thing. So if, whereas, yeah, good to have a look, not a grave concern if we say, oh, we need to wait.
Yes, and for those one related to GDK 21, that's something we should do with Jay. That was part of Jay process to integrate the GDK and every Java update and providing all the GDK. So I think that it will be able to deal with that, and I will be his back help. But that's not the, I don't think it's a priority. If I remember correctly, yes. That will be a side project.
Okay.
Infra represent, oh, this one will probably go to the backlog because that's a huge one. And we need to make sure what we choose and what we do about the account app. And that's not something we will take care of without dummy around. But this one we should go in the, how you call that, back burner?
Mm-hmm. Back burner is the correct phrase.
So yes, back burners. That's all, folks. Do you have something to add? Something I missed? I was quite fast. I probably missed something.
I don't have anything.
Okay. So I wish you a good week and talk to you next week on the 8th of October. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
You're welcome.